Hey guys, welcome to BNM Radio, the show that is intelligent but produced by not intelligent people.
It's true.
Today's show is sponsored by paper and plastic, and
especially this plastic.
I am Bowden Drake-Deese. Yeah, that plastic right there. It's completely recyclable. I am Bowden Drake-Deese.
I am Myles Ditkoff.
And I am Nik Morton.
This is BNM Radio.
Sure is.
And we are going to get right into it today with our first topic. Gentlemen.
What's our first topic, Bo?
Pineapple?
Is pineapple okay on pizza? That is our first topic.
What do you think?
Why don't you start, Myles? Because okay. I know you have a story.
Well, I just know that I love pineapple on pizza, and you can say what you want, but I've always liked Hawaiian pizza as my favorite pizza.
I would completely agree with that.
You would.
I really like pineapple on my pizza too, so I don't think we really have an argument here.
We don't at all.
So can we just talk? Can we just talk about how great it is?
Let's talk about why people
see. Because you know what's you know what's happening right now. What? Anybody who's watching this right now and absolutely hates it is either A, turning this off, or just wants to watch
just,
it so that they can get really upset.
We just lost all of our viewers. Yeah.
Exactly.
But they're also wrong.
I feel like
they are wrong.
I feel like if we talked to any other person in the world, they would have said that they don't like it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're like,
what are the chances that three
the chosen ones
that these three people? You know why this is why the show is going to work, because we're the only three people who just happen to end up in the same place and all like pineapple
on
their pizza.
Your friend Brendan loves
our friend Brendan.
Yes. Except for Bo's.
Yeah, no,
except
I don't really.
Bo has no idea. Yeah.
I don't really know him. I have no friends.
Well, anyway, that doesn't matter. That doesn't mean anything to any of our viewers.
Well, yes, but I was just saying because we every time. That's actually like my whole group of friends. Every time we ever order pizza and we're hanging out, we always order Hawaiian pizza.
Because it's good.
Yes, it's good, but it's just kind of surprising because all six of us are so.
Have you ever had pineapple and bacon pizza?
Yes.
No. It's interesting.
I mean, bacon's kind of ham.
Okay, you know what?
It's not kind of ham. It's from a different part, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
But
it's a lot fattier.
It's like the shoulder or something like that? Or is that bacon?
It's the rump.
It's the rump?
It's the rear end.
The ass end of bacon.
It is, yeah. I don't know where the bacon comes from.
That, you know, they say that eating a piece of bacon can take a day off your life. It's
really?
Maybe it's not a day.
That doesn't make any sense.
Maybe it's not a day, but it's
so
like,
if you
it's
eat,
like 24 minutes or something like that, some weird number.
If you eat one piece of bacon every day and a piece of apple every day, does that like cancel?
Well, no. Apple doesn't make you. Apple doesn't make you live longer. It just keeps doctors away.
Oh, it keeps the doctors away.
An apple a day keeps a doctor away.
Yeah.
Is that what it is? I haven't heard that.
They're like walking.
You've never heard that?
What? No.
Are you crazy?
I've just heard it like as a generic like term, like
okay, yeah,
like a bottle,
yeah,
it's
like a bottle of water a day keeps a doctor away.
No, it's a saying. It's definitely
that's,
an apple.
That is never a.
I don't. I'm not saying that that's a term,
that's
but I've
never
saying,
been said.
I'm saying no. It's just been said on this show. We've made history right now.
Yeah,
but
I'm saying I've only heard whatever a day keeps the doctor away as just one blanket term. I've never heard it used as just specifically an apple.
What do you guys think? Tell us on our Instagram page.
Or Facebook.
At BNM
Radio. No, we don't have a Facebook page.
No. At BNM Radio on Instagram.
Yeah. Okay. But I think that the whole apple a day thing is just dumb because I don't think I've ever had a doctor that's told me specifically like
to eat
apples.
An apple.
Yeah, they always tell you like, eat health. Eat your fruits and vegetables.
They don't even tell me to eat. They're just like, you eat. It's okay. And it's like,
get
some exercise at least.
Walk. You need to walk. And
right,
eat
right.
And eat an apple,
but not going runs because runs are boring.
Runs, you know.
Actually, you know what's funny? I was at the trainers the other day for physical therapy, and I asked him like, "What's the best way to you know get cut and like really build up your stamina and stuff
get
like that?"
What?
Like get cut, you know?
Yeah, like,
never.
Like fit.
Really heard that term?
You've never heard that?
Nah.
Okay.
You okay. Know. Go on though.
Anyway, there's a lot of terms that we just haven't heard of. We need to like get this together.
We need to like read a dictionary or something.
That's definitely not
Urban Dictionary.
Just
Urban
that'll
dictionary.
Be the next episode. It's just us reading a dictionary.
Anyway, so he said that running actually doesn't do a ton for you. Like it builds up your cardiovascular endurance and
well,
stuff
it doesn't
like
make
that.
You stronger.
No, it's not supposed to make you stronger.
Yeah.
But talking about building up and stuff like that. But people always say that the best way to burn fat is to run.
Mm-hmm.
But actually doing like heavy interval stuff, like if you lift really fast for a little bit, that's you're not getting stronger necessarily, but you're burning more fat
because more reps, less weight.
Exactly, because it works on those the muscle endurance rather than the actual muscle strength.
Yeah.
And
so
I don't know if that's
I have a question.
What?
Yes.
So what if you're someone like Myles and you don't have any fat? Just like
that is true. Myles has absolutely none.
If I ran, I just like. Crumpled to dust.
Got the wind to catch you,
yeah.
And you just fly off.
Yep.
Speaking of running, you guys want to hear a story?
I'd love to.
Okay, I think the viewers would love to.
I think the viewers would love to hear the story.
Let's hear this then.
So it's I was a sophomore, gym class, and we have to
run. I already hate this story.
We have to run the mile, and I was out on the track, and I was running as fast as I could, and I was next to my friend, and I looked down at the ground, and I was like, if you're running and you look at the ground, you don't see how much more you have to run, so it's easier. I said, it's easier if you look down. And just as I said that and looked down, I whacked my right leg into like this bench that was out in the middle of the track. And it was like a cartoon. I flew up onto the bench, and I was like, who puts a bench in the middle of a track?
Who looks down at the ground while they're running?
I still have, that was what, 3 years ago? I still have a gash on my leg from it.
You didn't put a Band-Aid on it and it's still open?
Well, no. It's like there's like a dent.
Okay.
There's just a dent in my leg.
You had a little fender bender.
In gym, did you guys try?
I tried, yeah.
The first year, yeah.
Yeah, first year I ran like a 6-minute mile.
Same. I mean, I didn't run, I ran like a 6:23 or something like that.
And then I was like, whoa, why did I feel bad
about myself?
Why would you run?
Mr. 8.5-minute mile.
That's not even that bad, though.
It's not that bad, but it's not as good as like 6 minutes.
The people that, whenever in gym class, the people that like walk.
Yeah, and that makes me so mad.
But then we go back in the gym and they're still running or they're still walking it. That's the people you feel bad for.
It's like,
well, not bad for.
No, but part of the time it's like, it doesn't even take that long to walk a mile.
Yeah,
it really
takes them like 20 minutes.
You have to try to not try.
It's not like a school,
but
like
they don't
walk.
Even start out running. They just walk.
Yeah. And it's like a leisurely walk.
It makes me mad to see
because
that.
I mean, my parents get mad at me all the time, like when we're just walking through the town.
Do they beat you?
Why do they get mad at you?
Should our viewers call
because the fact
child
that
services?
I walk really fast, and it's just because in school I walk fast because I have to get to my next class, but they haven't done that in 50 years. No, not 50 years. They're not that old.
That's cruel.
No, but in a few years. So they get mad because I just like walk my normal speed, but it's routinely faster than they are. But I don't know. It's like a weird thing because you never really think about it, but you just get faster walking because you're going to your classes.
I'm so slow walking right now. I mean, just because I know I have my foot surgery, but I haven't had to walk to a class in 4 months.
Because
so
I've been used to skirting.
Uh-huh. We're gonna feature that on the next episode.
Oh,
by
yeah.
the way, it's gonna make a comeback.
It's gone.
Scooter.
The scooter's gone.
Isn't it like?
No,
trash.
I still have it. It's in my trunk.
Oh,
it's like the most rickety scooter.
You should have scootered
seen.
Into the studio.
I should have scooted it. That's the intro.
Oh yeah, that's the intro. Oh wait, yeah. Well, people will see that. They've already seen the intro.
Yeah.
The intro already happened. We're in the
it
middle
did.
Of the show.
I know. Come on, man. Like they know what we're talking about.
Yeah,
they definitely know
yeah.
more than we do at this point.
That is very true.
We don't even know
they
what the hell's going on.
They can skip half of this and see what we end with.
We're being a little vague, but we haven't made an intro yet. We're going to make it today after the show and stitch it in.
We pretended for half a second that we were definitely going to do that, and it kind of worked.
Yeah.
Well, we are going to do that.
I know we are going to
do that.
We
have a plan.
But then we just kept rolling with it.
Yeah. And by plan, you guys have seen our plan unveiled.
Okay,
unveiled?
Let's move on.
Is that not the term for that?
Unveiled.
Unveiled?
Unveiled? It's like not unveiled. Baby cow.
veal.
Have you ever had veal?
No, I refuse to eat it.
Why?
I don't like the practice. I don't like the practice of...
The practice of eating babies?
Well, I mean,
yeah.
they can live
eat
nice...
babies all the time.
What are you talking about?
I'm sure you've eaten baby pigs that are bacon now.
Well, I mean, if you've ever eaten like... McDonald's chicken, I don't think that they...
That's not chicken.
I don't think they...
It's definitely not chicken.
I don't think they sort it out. I think they just grab whatever's
there. I feel like their chicken nuggets are like wet styrofoam or something like that.
There's definitely chicken in it.
Well, have you ever seen
some
the movie,
kind of chicken.
Supersize Me? It's a hoax. Did you know that?
Really?
What do you mean
I just found
hoax?
Out like last week. I'm so mad.
How'd you find that out?
What do you mean it's a hoax?
It's like it's not real. It's fake.
But what's not real about it? The fact that McDonald's is gross or the fact that...
They faked that he like ate all that and...
But they eat all that. That's
how do you
not,
fake that?
That's not that bad of a problem.
Well, no, they like, they made him, he didn't, I mean, I don't know a whole lot about it, but I guess he didn't really get that, because he was really sick from it.
Yeah.
Right.
But I don't think he was really that sick.
Wait, so let me ask.
Look it up on the
follow-up
laptop
question.
And we'll come
follow-up
back
question.
To it.
Okay, well,
do
if
you
it ever
think
loads.
That, do you think that he just didn't get really sick, or you know he didn't get really sick?
All I know is that it's a hoax. That's all. That's
it's
all
fake
I
news.
Have.
It's fake news.
This is CNN.
Fake news.
Is it confirmed that it's a hoax?
Literally, somebody told me that it was a hoax, and I was like,
six what? Famous documentaries that were shockingly full of crap.
Interesting.
I want to hear this list.
2005. This isn't recent.
Oh.
When did Super Size Me come out?
It's an old documentary.
Is it like 90? It's not 90.
I don't know. I watched it every year for like 7 years.
I think it came out in
2004-ish.
What? Came out in 2004? Is it on the list?
Yeah.
Well, read us the list.
I'm going to... Well,
as a hoax?
Well, I'm actually looking at a different article, so keep talking.
Okay. All right.
Let's keep talking.
We're going to just keep talking.
I don't know if that's... I don't know. Okay, we're silent right now.
Well, it's hard to tell because...
We don't have to fill up every second.
I don't know.
Every single second.
Every single second.
Okay, I'll read you this six favorite documentaries when it loads.
When it loads.
You don't have the best of internet.
You need to, like, tell me.
It hasn't loaded yet.
It hasn't loaded yet? Is it loaded now?
As you can see.
Oh, I can't see it.
Partly loaded.
It's loading. We're getting there. Here we go.
Number six, Super Size Me.
Let's keep going.
I don't know if it says exactly why. It says, so he decided he would only eat food sold by McDonald's, which is... what it says in the movie. Let's see. Average of 5,000 calories a day, which is insane.
But what actually happened?
It doesn't even... Oh, here we go. Okay. No one has been... Oh, wait, no. That doesn't... Oh, here we go. Okay, so basically, they say they don't know it's a hoax. And so, this website that it say... But,
so then this is crap.
But they said...
Because then they don't know it's a hoax. They're a hoax.
Basic,
fake news.
Basic math. And,
what website is this on?
I don't know.
We didn't probably, set our sources.
Probably not. Hold on. Good website. But it just says that basic
cracked.
Math.
Cracked.com.
Oh, that's... Wait. Oh, no. Cracked is the good... I was thinking of the Onion.
It just basically says but basic math disputes the claim that it can't. He can't like have 5,000 calories a day because the food he ate doesn't add up to that. Oh. So they say that he didn't actually eat that much.
You're
so
telling me
not,
you can't eat 5,000
no,
calories
not
worth of...
The things he listed that he ate each day doesn't add
up
to
5,000.
Which means either... Which means he probably wasn't actually as sick as...
I mean, I'm sure there were elements of truth to that, but I don't know if it was completely...
Also, if they're making a film like that, there's definitely going to be some dramatization of some kind. That's what you're saying?
Yeah.
Okay.
With good. Elements of truth.
Good point, Nick. Good point.
Thanks, Bo.
Do I get a point for that?
Or do we get... Oh, I don't know.
Are we giving out
points? We get,
oh, yeah.
We're going to have to explain it.
We have to explain it. You're going to explain it?
Should I? No, I don't know.
No?
How would we explain it?
How would we explain it?
So if you've ever been to a school board meeting, that's what this game is.
So I'll explain it.
Okay, go ahead.
So basically... There is an original board of members for this game, and it's Myles, it's me, it's Nick, it's Alex Clues. That's the original board.
Right, right.
And basically the game is whenever somebody says something funny that we're going to remember.
Or does something cool.
Does something
it's
cool.
It's just whenever you
like,
feel like a word.
If you walked into the classroom and did a backflip, you would get a few points for
Nick,
that
can
probably.
You do a backflip?
Well, in order to get a few points, you would have to go through the board, which is us.
Yeah. You'd have to make a request.
You'd have to.
I hope you guys know that the other five documentaries I've never heard in my life.
Okay, we're talking about our game.
Yeah,
right
we're
now.
Moving
no,
on.
No, I know, but
get off that.
I'm not even gonna
get
say
off.
That.
Get
hold the phone.
It is
wait
gone.
Stop the presses.
Okay.
Anyway,
so where were we?
So
the game.
Like if I
yes
if I took this bottle.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Wow.
And I flipped it.
And if I
flipped it. Right now, and make it. Do I get a point?
You would get a point
if I flip it and make it on the first try. Will I get a point?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right. I'm gonna do it.
You're not
but
gonna
make
do
sure
it.
That cap is on because there's
yeah,
an audio
I know,
mixer
I know,
right
I know,
here
I know.
And lots of and a computer.
Yeah.
You will pay lots of money.
I'm not.
And if you lose it, you're gonna have to get up and get it or leave it there.
I'm gonna have to get. I'll get up and get it. You guys
just go for it.
You're gonna
just
have to
go
keep
for
going.
And you suck.
That was so bad.
That was horrendous.
That was so bad.
And we're done with that. Thanks for playing.
Done.
I get it there. I mean, I know you can't
nobody
see it.
Nobody
so
can see
say,
that, so it didn't happen.
Yeah, I didn't even
no,
see
hold
it,
up.
So you
I'm
could
gonna,
be lying.
I'm
pick,
stand,
sir, it didn't happen.
I'm going to stand up and do it.
Oh, God.
Bo. You just ruined the wide shot. No one can see you.
I know no one can see me, but I had to.
Well, this is a radio show, so As long as they can hear us, I guess we're fine.
Yeah, that's true. But we're not just going to put the audio out.
What?
Nothing.
Okay.
What do you mean, what?
I wasn't listening. I was thinking.
Why not?
Sometimes
you need to
be vigilant.
It's not like that's the point of the show or anything. You're supposed to listen.
Sometimes I think about things and then I don't listen to what people are saying.
Wait, so, Bo, you've not seen this Pepsi commercial.
I have not
seen
this
Pepsi commercial. I really want to talk about this Pepsi commercial.
Let's talk about the Pepsi commercial.
Okay, have you seen it?
I kind of half saw it. I saw a meme of it.
Okay.
So it wasn't the real thing.
If you play the commercial for me right now, we can talk about it.
It will not play.
It will not play.
This internet.
Well, how about I bring it up?
We are sorry for the bad internet.
Let me bring it up on my phone.
It's loading. It probably will never load.
So anyway.
Oh, here we go.
Tell us about it. What is it about?
It's just... It's the every Pepsi commercial where every single person in the commercial is drinking Pepsi. But it's a lot about, like, police brutality, right? And okay. I feel like a lot of the memes and stuff that we're seeing right now, and the reason I don't... Hey, it's playing. I mean, it's also... Volume is up.
All right, we're gonna go ahead and watch this, and we're gonna put it up so that the viewers can see it, and then we'll talk about it
once this ad is over.
I don't know if we can do that. Can we do that?
We can totally do that.
Okay, let's do it.
Okay, once the ad is over. But anyway, so I think that the dumb thing is that it's like police brutality, but every scene it's basically they're giving a policeman a Pepsi,
okay,
and like that's not gonna solve anything. And it makes me mad because...
Well, that is yet to be seen.
So is this a stupid argument?
I mean, has anybody tried that?
It's a stupid argument, but...
Is it like one of those things that people are getting all heard over on the internet that doesn't really mean anything?
Probably.
I mean, it does mean things, though.
Because I still don't really know what it is.
Okay.
Or why people are upset.
Okay, here we go.
It.
We're gonna put it up, and then we'll react.
Once. Okay. We are the lions. We are the chosen. We're going to shine out the door. Yeah, we are the movement. This generation. You better know.
All right,
welcome back.
Yeah, I don't know how to feel about that. I don't like the commercial. I mean, I think it's nice to have an idea where, you know, we have an idea where something would connect police back with the community.
Yeah,
but Pepsi?
Yeah, exactly. That's why I feel like, out of all things, if you're gonna make a commercial or if you're gonna make a video, talking about police brutality,
it should at the very least be Coca-Cola. Because you always no
we're not starting that
no listen to my point first. Everybody, when you go to a restaurant and you want soda, you always ask for Coke
and
first.
Then they say is Pepsi okay? And you say yes, and inside you're dying.
Exactly.
Well, I don't drink soda.
Okay,
so
I don't soda in general.
I'm more of a juice guy.
Yeah, me too. I don't drink it either.
Soda, really, I love root beer is the best.
That's
I don't drink root
no,
beer.
I can't do that.
Anyway,
root beer was the first soda that I stopped drinking. I used to drink everything, but then it just kind of slowly died down.
Okay, we're getting off topic.
Yes.
But,
off topic, it's a radio show.
I know it's
a radio
show.
Want. Okay, anyway.
Anyway. I think it's a good idea to have something like that out there and playing. But
does Pepsi need to make a commercial?
Pepsi
about
does
that?
Not
There's
need,
no reason.
Pepsi does not need to make that commercial.
Did you see the Super Bowl where... I forget which, it was a beer company, I think, and they made that, like, Back to Your Roots video, but it was it was low-key, like, roasting Trump.
Yeah, it was Budweiser.
The immigration thing, yeah.
Yeah, it was Budweiser.
I didn't
that's,
see it.
That was a,
that
that's
was a, an amazing commercial.
It was a
and
great,
great
commercial.
Pepsi doesn't really make sense.
Yeah. Because the thing about that commercial, you didn't see it?
No.
Oh.
It's very good.
Whatever.
It's I'll very, show you later.
Yeah, I'll watch it later.
I'm sure everyone else has seen it.
So then we're going to talk
about it. Yeah, because
they're
not
me. Nick doesn't like football.
We're going to talk about it, and then
you
can jump in.
I saw a few of the commercials. So.
But anyway.
It's also unfair that our TV production teacher made us watch every single commercial from the Super Bowl.
I did watch every single one.
I didn't do
but
it, though.
Super Bowl commercials are so good. Did you see the Expedia one?
Which one was
where that? It was like it started with the old man in the train, and then it was that was a great commercial.
My favorite was the Secret Society for the avocados. That was so funny.
That was. I showed you that, like, and then you showed Bo, and then Bo showed someone else.
Yeah, I don't care.
That, like, we watched it like 50 times.
Showed, like, Alex.
So anyway,
I was I was like, Alex, you're drunk. You like this?
About that video, the video we watched, the Pepsi video.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I forgot what I was gonna say about it. Anyway, so it seems like the kind of thing that it's like, who cares? You know,
who cares about what?
Yeah,
who cares?
Police
it's a commercial. Who cares?
Like, I feel like it's just dumb.
It's stupid.
But there's
it's stupid to get upset about it. It's no, just
but
a commercial.
It's not necessarily getting upset, but it's like, does somebody have the, like, is this the right person to be talking about this? Because, like,
Kendall Jenner, the face of police brutality.
She's not the
that
face.
That doesn't sound like a good
thing.
She is a rich white girl. The face of police
minority.
Brutality. Does that mean she was, like, beat and now her face
no
represents police brutality?
No, she wasn't. That's the point. She has no, she has no connection to
it's
that whatsoever.
It's ironic because she is the opposite of everything that...
I feel like we shouldn't
even be talking about this because we can't be saying anything.
Why not?
Because we're not black.
I mean, I guess
that's a minority.
You have to be black to talk about it.
No, but it rarely happens.
I guess.
To other people.
Actually, and to be honest, it's usually like people like us being brutal to the police.
Exactly. Wait, what?
Yeah.
Wait.
Okay. Let's rewind.
Oh, no. Yeah. I see what you mean.
Let's rewind a couple years ago and go back to Pumpkin Fest. Okay.
Pumpkin Fest. I was there.
Yes,
me too.
You were there.
I was there. I was on the TV crew.
covering the riot.
I was on the camera riot. When Ruth Sterling snagged the microphone, tried to
oh
take
my
it
god
away from
that was
what's
so
his face.
Funny.
I don't think I saw that.
No, that was crazy. She came
what
in
was
and
his
she
name?
Was like screaming. Jared Goodell.
Yeah, Jared Goodell.
And he was like, roll the cameras. And
Zach
were,
Sang was here too.
Yeah, I hung out with him all day. It was pretty cool.
Same, not really.
He hates him.
I don't hate. Yeah.
He hates Zach Sang.
Oh, I do?
It's not that he I does. Hate him.
You do? I don't like him either.
It's not that really. I hate him. It's that I don't like him on the radio.
He's a cool guy to hang out with in
his
person.
His radio personality is just that's disgusting.
What, yeah, I agree
annoying.
With that. I don't like to listen
like
to
when
him.
When I listen to it on the radio, I have to change the channel. It's just annoying to me.
The only reason I would listen to him is to listen to the music, but all
the music
on the station is
the music
crap,
gets good after 7 o'clock.
Like,
I don't really like that
music. Zach Sang gang... So annoying.
I don't like his game.
I met his the girl too. What's her name?
I don't know.
Zach.
I don't know. I work there. I don't even know.
You work in Los Angeles, or it's a New York show,
City.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
But they're in New York when.
But
they
I work
that?
At 103.7
so.
On KNEFM.
They send it out to a bunch of radio stations. It's a huge show. That's why
we play
it was special that they
we
were
play
there.
America's Top 40 at the beginning of every day.
Hmm. I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's just, weird. But doesn't he say like Keen things?
Yeah.
Well, no, there's like a station ID that
they have
the
to run
station
through.
Records themselves and plays over it.
Okay.
But he doesn't, he just does his show. Hmm. It's kind of, it would kind of like if we did our show and then sent it out and other stations played it.
But that's never going to happen.
It will someday. You just need to believe.
Believe.
Yeah, okay.
Actually, we're playing this on Cheshire TV, and Cheshire TV sends out their content to public access stations around the country.
Oh.
Like the show Cinemaniacs, Tom Cook is one of the hosts, and he was recognized in like Chicago.
I've never seen that show or heard of it.
It's a good show. You should watch it. I watch every episode because I direct it. But.
Oh,
it's too
well, that
bad
would
that
be
no
why.
One else watches.
It's kind of weird not watching it at home because
I don't even know how to get to public access TV on my own television.
You're what's wrong with the world?
I mean. See, hey, my parents
okay,
are...
but we know just flat out.
Literally,
so
public
that,
access
so that
is
everybody
the best
else
thing
knows,
ever.
I am not the tech guy here. I know nothing about
you
what's
know,
going on. I don't know how this
don't
microphone
think you
have to be
works. Techie
for that. I barely knew how to plug in my microphone.
He's like, does it go in this one or this one?
Yeah,
this one?
I was like,
that one.
Why don't the three pegs go into the not three pegs?
XLR. What?
Yeah, it's simple.
I know it's an
there's the male and
I know
the female.
I got you. That.
It's pretty simple.
I had to explain.
See, all you
got to
do is make sure that the cords are having sex with each other.
That's
and then it works.
That's right. Literally exactly what you have to do, though.
Yeah, that's exactly why they do that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, what? I thought you were going to say a statement or something.
I don't know.
Okay, I'm going to continue with the TV topic. My parents are kind of weird about it. We only get the like 5 basic channels.
Oh,
like
yeah.
ABC, oh, yeah. NBC, CBS.
How come?
Do you have Time Warner?
Yeah.
Well, that's your mistake.
Well, no.
Well, that doesn't have any different. You can buy all the channels if you want.
Oh, you only get like a
we only pay like $10 a month for the basic package.
You don't, but you don't get Cheshire TV channel 8.
I mean, we probably do. I've never looked.
Channel 8, channel 10.
I'm just saying.
I mean,
though,
I don't get it because I
support your local TV stations.
I have satellite, so I don't get it.
I don't even know why we have a TV. I don't watch TV ever.
I use mine for like Netflix and.
I mean, I play video games like I play on the Xbox and stuff, but I'd never watch TV.
I have like, I feel like I had a lot more shows that I wanted to watch. Like it started to go away now. Like the whole college stuff is starting to ramp up.
Oh yeah.
And I've had a hard time keeping up with the. I know that hard time keeping up with the Big Bang Theory, and
that's been going on for years.
I know it is, but I've kept up with it.
But
I'm saying, love it.
You can always go back and watch.
Yeah.
You can, but keeping up with new shows and being there to watch them every night and
yeah.
Like it's such
like,
a chore.
I don't even have a Netflix.
You don't have Netflix?
And my parents have a Prime, is that what it's called?
Amazon Prime.
Yeah, is it called a Prime account or something?
Yes. And you get like
Prime TV, that's what it is.
You can like rent movies and stuff.
Yeah, it's like Netflix just worse. Because
yeah,
not as much.
There's no TV on it, is it?
No.
I don't think
and
so.
You have to rent everything, don't you?
No. There's like Amazon Prime.
So you have to pay for the subscription, and then you have to pay for the things you want to watch?
It's exactly everything.
Like Netflix. It's just
Amazon Prime isn't just the streaming software. It's like it's everything. You get like reduced shipping, don't you, or something?
Free shipping on everything.
Free
on,
two-day
like
shipping
anything?
Or something.
Anything at all?
Everything. Unless
it's not. It's not just their streaming thing. It's like everything.
It's because it's so Prime.
It's actually, I love it. I order everything from Amazon.
Oh, yeah.
I don't go on Amazon for anything.
I try to order one thing a month just because I like getting packages.
You know what I do too with my Hulu account?
What?
Because I have to pay for it. So what I do is I get the full package, which is like ad-free. And then I threaten to cancel my subscription. And they say, we'll give you a free month if you continue. And then after that month, I'll pay for a month. And then I'll threaten to cancel. So I only have to pay every other month.
My parents
and they just
my
keep
mom
doing that?
Did that with Sirius.
So far, it's
XM.
Done that. Yeah,
because
if you threaten to leave, it's $11 a month.
Yeah,
they're not losing anything.
My mom was getting close to the end of her Sirius thing, like XM. What is it called? Free trial, I guess.
Satellite radio
in her car, and so she called them up, and they're like, "You can get it $5 off, or whatever." And she's like, "I really, really, really want it," but like, she basically just like. Threatened to cancel it like you do.
Right.
And then they were like, okay, fine. We'll give it to you really cheap. And then she's like, there you go.
It's just pretty funny that there's like no limit.
Got it.
It just happens every time. Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, now that I let out the secret, they're going to stop.
Yeah, I know. Why'd you say it?
Yeah. I'm sorry.
Because maybe I was going to try, but now I'm
not
going to
have
it out. Yeah. We need one of those like bleep things.
So let's talk about something really quick. Those Amazon, like the Alexa things.
Yeah.
I heard that if you say, is the government watching me, they shut off.
And if you say, are you connected to the CIA?
They shut off.
Yeah, but it's not. It's just because Amazon thinks they're funny.
Oh, it's a joke?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. It's
I'm not, that's like
Nick's like, oh, no, they're connected.
That's well, like when you're at a friend's house and like their dad named the Wi-Fi like FBI surveillance van or something like that.
I got so scared last year. I was at home and I was on the Wi-Fi, or I went to the Wi-Fi thing because it wasn't connecting. I looked in one of the Wi-Fis that I've never seen before, and usually it's only my home like Wi-Fi that's available from like in my room. And it was like FBI van, and I was like, "What?" I was looking out the window.
First of all,
is an FBI van?
If an FBI van was outside your house and they had their own internet connection,
it was private.
Do you think they would call it FBI van if they were like staking out your house?
I mean, yeah, you don't think about that.
It's like putting a sign on the outside of their van. It's like,
Jerry,
this
Jerry.
Is an FBI van.
Jerry, listen to me. We have to have our Wi-Fi. What should we name it? We got to make sure we're hiding. Let's call it FBI van.
Or no, they would call it not FBI van.
Not FBI. It's genius.
It was just confusing to me because there's usually not Wi-Fi. Then it's an FBI van. I was like, there's a
interesting.
Chance.
There's a chance. Are you afraid the government's watching you?
I mean,
they're definitely watching us.
You get your phone, always watching you.
Yeah, I know.
Facebook sells our information.
Okay. All right. So we're going to change topics here, but I'm going to formally introduce the topic.
Okay.
How do you feel about the government watching you?
That's what we're talking about.
I know, but I'm formally introducing the topic.
Okay, yes, but go on your Facebook thing, because that's a really interesting thing.
So the reason that I learned this is a police officer came into school and was telling us a story about some raccoon that he shot in some backyard.
Wait, who did?
Some police officer talking about a raccoon.
I hope this story just gets more relevant because right now when you open with
I'm government watching me
and raccoon that police officer shot.
Do you know this police officer? Or just
he came into this. I don't know who it was.
Okay.
Anyway, he came and he was telling a story about how he went to these people's house and they had a raccoon and they thought it was rabid and they said, "What do we do about it?" And he pulled out his gun and shot it. He just didn't say anything. And these guys were really freaked out because they weren't expecting it. So they did something. Maybe that's a different... He told two stories, so that... That story... That story is completely irrelevant.
What does this have to do with Facebook?
Nick!
Okay, so the Facebook
story.
Get
out of the show.
Oh my God, just take a time out. Me and Myles will take over for a little bit. Oh my God.
That was completely irrelevant. So anyway...
Now you just exposed this police officer.
Okay, it was cyberbullying. Some kids were cyberbullying.
Was it the raccoon?
He went to Facebook and told them that he needed the Facebook messages. And they said that he thought that it was really cool that they had it. They save everything for 13 years before it's deleted off their servers.
Did he go to Facebook or did he go to the kids?
13 years?
He went to Facebook.
Okay. You can do that?
You just, it's like, you need like a court order, a subpoena or something. Okay. But he was a police officer. I'm sure it's not hard to get it when you're a police officer.
Yeah, it's probably not.
He said that it was cool that they kept information for that long for the police, they could see it. But they told him that the reason that they kept it is because...
They sell to ads.
And I'm finally getting to my point.
Yeah.
The reason that they keep it for so long is because they sell it to advertising companies. Anyway, so they know what people want. I'll be on Google and I'll type in audio mixer and it'll pop up audio mixer, and then I'll go on YouTube and literally the first ad they show me is an ad for an audio mixer.
It's
crazy how fast that they get information.
Half a year ago, I was on this like goalie hockey website and I was looking at like these cool things, and then I went on Facebook and it's like all the ads are hockey, and I was
it's crazy, it's so weird because they use cookies. I don't know if you're familiar with
same
with like airlines. If you go through a bunch of airline websites, they save your cookies, and every time that you research for the same flight, they jack up the price because they know you're looking for it.
Oh, huh. I've never heard of that.
So why would they jack up the price? That would like make you not
want to
see it.
Because they want to scare you into buying it before it goes higher.
Yeah.
That doesn't scare me into buying that. Just if I see one price that I like and then I go back and then it's jacked up, I'm like, well, guess I'm not going.
But if you need to go, that's why they do that. But
a teenager.
There is a loophole. And I'll share it with our viewers.
Don't share it. No. Tell me.
Why would we not
put it on the next episode? I want to know this first.
You want me to whisper it into your ear before we
yes,
tell it on the
yes,
show?
Yes, I do.
I'm just going to say
it. Put the mic away right now.
What is it? But what is it? Be real here. Also, your mic's going to fall off.
That's screwed in.
Oh, okay.
Oh, it's screwed in.
Well, why don't you work on that, and I will tell people about the loophole.
No, Miles has a question.
I have a question. When is the next time you think you're going to buy a plane ticket you yourself?
This summer.
What for?
Spain.
What a nerd.
You're not buying it. Government knows now.
There's no way you're buying that. Your parents are going to buy that.
No, I'll buy it.
Why?
My parents won't pay for it, and I will have to.
Can you talk into that microphone, buddy?
I'm fixing it, Nick.
Well, no one can hear you if you're not in the microphone.
It doesn't turn more.
It's because you need to loosen this to turn it.
Oh.
Now that we have figured out our technical issues.
You know what I just realized, Nick? They still can never see your face.
Because I'm just so short, but whatever. So the loophole.
Go ahead.
Incognito mode.
Yeah.
Incognito mode doesn't use, or it's like private browsing, it doesn't use cookies.
I know that.
Yeah.
And the shortcut, I think, the shortcut's Control Shift N. So if you're ever looking for like plane tickets,
or you just push the three dots in the top right corner.
I wish you wouldn't talk to me like that. I'm giving them the shortcut. Yeah, I know how to do it. That's how I used to do it until they gave me the shortcut. But anyway, if you browse airlines in incognito mode. What?
You're all about shortcuts.
Literally, that's all I do is shortcuts.
On Premiere, when every 2 seconds, you're like, oh, and this is this shortcut and this shortcut. And this
I have one hand on the mouse and one hand on the keyboard, and it's the whole time I'm just going tick, 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 tick.
I hate shortcuts.
It's so easy.
They're hard for me to remember. I don't have that much space in my brain.
Once you remember it, it's second nature, and it's just like the quickest edit.
I'm sorry, though. I just made you totally go off.
What were we talking about?
I don't know.
Oh, incognito mode.
Yeah.
So, yeah, just do it. And then they won't jack up the prices because they can't see that you've searched for it before.
So if you go into incognito mode before
buying your before flight tickets.
Yeah. I'm having a hard time talking.
Hey, someone name a country.
Kenya.
Sure. I'm going to see if I can do this. Keep talking.
We're not going to keep talking. We're going to watch. Oh, fun fact about Kenya, actually.
Okay.
I don't have a fun fact about Kenya. I just thought maybe I'd make one up.
Obama is from Kenya.
Don't even go there. Don't do
that's
that.
That's awful. Anyway,
we're not that kind
He's
of show.
He's from Hawaii.
Anyway, what do we have on this list here? Let's talk about some new technology.
What do you got for new technology?
Samsung S8.
The S8 just came out.
Don't trust it.
Or it was announced.
Don't trust
it's
it.
Awesome. What do you mean don't trust it?
I mean,
it's
awesome.
No. Okay.
It's not going to blow up, so don't even say that.
No, they say it's not going to blow up, but they didn't say that the other one was going to blow up either. Okay?
They didn't say that it wasn't going to blow up. They just didn't know that it was going to blow up.
Okay, but they don't know that this one's going to blow up
either. No, you know why they do? Because they re-released the Note.
Yeah, they just re-released it with the new battery.
That doesn't matter.
Yeah, it doesn't.
Yes, it
why
does.
Why would it matter for the first one? The first one should explode too. First one should not explode in the first place.
Both.
Have you heard of an iPhone exploding yet?
Yeah, I have.
Where?
It was like.
Did you know
a few
if you put your iPhone in the microwave, it charges faster?
Stop.
Disclaimer: Don't actually. Wait, we are not responsible for
Nick,
broken phones.
I have
phones.
A really good story about that.
Okay.
About microwaves and not
go ahead.
Phones, but
microwaves.
So
just
I
microwaves.
Used to. You guys ever play on the DS?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, so me and my sister, I had a DS Lite, and she had just the DS whatever regular.
Oh, yeah?
We would play Mario Bros. And it was like, since this is like, I mean, it's not that long ago, but it's long ago enough that the Wi-Fi, or not even Wi-Fi, connection kind of was just ass.
Yeah.
And
it just was.
Yeah.
It was a butt. It was a butt.
To get better connection, we would think that like, an enclosed space, it's better because the signal can just bounce right back
because
we're not smart, you know, it has to go to satellites and back.
So what you want, like a piece of tin foil?
So we put it inside the microwave. No. And it's not just we'd put it inside the microwave and just wait for it to
you put your DS in the microwave?
Yeah, both of them.
You put your
both
of them.
Of the DSs,
oh my god.
But you didn't turn it on, did you?
Well,
you thought you could boost it?
Well,
boost it with the
you turn on the popcorn. Turn on the popcorn
thinking,
thing, maybe boost the signal.
I don't really know what we were thinking, but I guess we would turn it on and as they would go around, and it always connect immediately.
you just wanted the motion.
Oh,
I don't know. I guess
so it actually worked.
It worked.
Did it destroy it?
No, we'd only do it for like a second. So
a second.
It wouldn't, or like 5 seconds. So it wouldn't like.
5 seconds. You put your DS in the microwave for 5 seconds.
I mean, as long as it's only in there for a few seconds.
And then we took them out, and they'd be
connected. We are still not responsible for
any
exploding technology.
We're not responsible for anything.
And so we just keep putting them in there every time we want to connect.
Kids,
it's the weirdest
thing. Put things that are supposed to heat things up that aren't supposed to be in there, like tinfoil or any kind of metal in a microwave. You will have a great time.
Tinfoil is a lot of fun to put in the microwave.
My dad.
What does it do?
My dad never told me about it.
I feel like that's
actually
bad.
No. My dad told me about it. He said that if you put metal in the microwave, it'll like catch on fire. I was like, how bad will it catch on fire? He said, let's see. And he puts this huge thing of tinfoil in the microwave and just turns it on. And like, we had to buy a new microwave because the inside of it was ruined.
It destroys it.
My mom was so mad at him. It was hilarious.
There's these videos on the internet where they put everything in microwaves. I've seen, they like put a mini microwave into a microwave and they drilled a hole so they could power the mini microwave.
Hey, how does that work? Remember the price 174?
It's not a mini microwave. It's just a smaller microwave.
Okay. $174 to fly to
Atlanta.
To Atlanta?
I honestly don't know.
What happened to Kenya?
Yeah.
Do they have airports in Kenya?
Yes, they do, Nick.
I'm
like,
sorry.
What kind of like that's reputation are you building for yourself on our show?
I'm sorry.
That's bad.
Well, I mean, there's...
You're going to be like the racist comment guy.
The racist... Racist?
That was pretty racist.
I am far from racist.
What? That's exactly what a racist would say.
It's basic geography. I'm sorry.
I love everyone that... if people are listening to this, just the audio, they couldn't have heard us just...
Like, there was a scene. I look, then he looks.
Yep. Oh my god!
No, it was they could feel
the tension from the momentary silence.
The air.
That should be the name of the radio show. It should be
momentary silence.
No, momentary tension.
But momentary he didn't say tension.
That. Momentary racism.
Hey, look at the time.
What?
It's 4:20.
Well, would you look at the time?
It is time for us to get a life.
Time to drink up.
Yeah.
How does that make any sense?
So. Do we have anything to talk about the essay besides the, forgetting the blowing up thing and the microwaves and the battery?
The display looks nice.
Well, yeah, it's like the entire
phone. It is beautiful and it's taller.
Have you seen what's supposed to be happening for the iPhone 8?
Well, it's there's always speculation.
Yeah, no one knows.
No, but there was this thing that I saw on.
Yeah. Tell me about it. I'll just stand there.
No, I saw that this whole... So, if you look at your iPhone, you got your iPhone here, and then you take this whole part.
Your everyday average iPhone?
Everything. This whole part is screen.
Oh, yeah. They've been talking about that for so long.
The S8's pretty
Your home button's even a screen?
That is literally the S8 with just a tiny bit of black.
And also better.
Because the home button's built in, plus...
Hey, just so you know the prices did go up.
Did they?
I told you.
It was 174.
183.
You know.
Wow.
You know what I...
See if you can replicate the results.
With what?
Get off and go back on.
That's what he just
did.
Do it again.
So you know what I don't like about...
174 to 183.
Sure. Okay, go.
So what I don't like about the new Samsung?
Yeah.
The fingerprint scanner is on the back.
Why is that a problem?
To log in.
But you realize you don't use that. It's face. They have face scan now.
But I don't like that.
Why? You do this and boom, you're in.
What if someone held a picture up with that? Do it?
No, I can't.
What do you mean it can't?
It's got to be like 3D.
It's like 3D.
So?
You can't.
So?
If someone held your face up to it.
It's so easy,
Nick, just
to
saying
take
so
my phone
is
out
not
and
a valid
put my
argument.
Thumb on it. I just whip it out and put my thumb on it and it turns on.
See, I am done with the iPhone once I get an upgrade.
Yeah.
Why?
Well, I want to go to the iPhone 8.
Why? See, the literally only thing that is better about the iPhone than Samsung is the fact that you can group text and it's not awful. Because it's the iMessage, right? Pretty much iMessage is the only thing better about iPhones. And I don't really text much anymore. Snapchat pretty much, always. And so I'm like, might as well go to the superior phone.
I just like my iPhone more.
The reason that I like iPhone is because they're pretty. They're beautiful.
They're such elegant pieces.
Don't you not have an iPhone?
I have a Samsung Galaxy Note 5.
It's going to blow.
Yeah.
No, it's the 5, so it's
That's what
good.
The timer's for. When we hit zero.
Yeah, it's true. But I mean, it's so easy just to kind of touch it.
So you can do the same thing with
touchy,
this.
Touchy, touchy.
Look.
My meme chat.
I didn't even have to touch it twice. I just
and by your meme chat you mean beep. Mine?
No, mine.
I invited you.
I have more than one. You what?
I have a Chapsnat.
A meme chat?
Chapsnat.
Hey, the price didn't go up this time.
It didn't.
Nope.
Still 183.
Well, okay. I'm sorry that
disproved.
It didn't go up.
It's fake.
It's automatically fake.
Fake news.
One time.
So anyway, where are we on this? Where are we on this show? Should we introduce our guest?
We should introduce our
guest. Hello, I'm the guest.
Well, that wasn't funny at all. Next joke.
We don't have any more jokes. We're out.
How about some live music?
Some live music?
We'll bring a keyboard in here sometime. You can bring a guitar. Yeah. Miles can watch.
Hey, I used to play the saxophone.
Miles will bring in his saxophone.
I definitely won't do that because I haven't played it in 4 years.
So why did you
years?
Suggest it?
I just said I have... Once
you have one?
I have. I actually do. I have like 7. My dad plays.
You have 7 saxophones.
Probably
can I have
5?
One?
No. They're really expensive. Oh, no. You know how much saxophones are?
a lot of money. Yeah, I know.
We have a tenor, a soprano. What's the?
You're such a nerd.
Alto. What do you mean?
Who cares about all the different types of saxophones?
The soprano's the best because it's the highest.
Okay,
tenor. It's the highest.
I've come up with a
Barry. That's the.
I've come up with a new. I've come up with a new segment. Come up with a new segment.
Bo is dumb.
I don't know if you can just come up with a new segment right on.
I do. I have a new segment. I have a new segment right now.
Okay, go ahead.
The segment is called Nik Morton Says.
Okay.
The game.
I feel like this is going to be really dumb.
We have to say things that Nick has said or not said, and Nick has to tell us if it's something he would say.
If it's something that I have to say if I've said that or not?
You have to say if you said it or not, or if you would.
Okay, shoot.
The only thing is, though, usually in segments, you know, you have these things planned. Yeah.
See, we're dumb, so we're just going to go with it, and it's our first show.
Do you want to show the audience our planning sheet?
I don't think I do, actually.
I was making mac and cheese when I wrote this. We'll take a nice screenshot of that. All righty.
You ready to go?
Go. You can try.
Nonsense. Sponsor. Sand. Lettuce.
You just gave it all away. Thanks.
Is that the meat, or is the sponsorship the meat of the sandwich?
What?
That says sand. Yeah. There is no which part to that.
Can we move on?
Well, I was thinking, I thought you were writing it. Let's play this. I thought you were writing the show like a sandwich.
No.
Oh.
Okay.
Throw that out the window.
I'm ready. Stop slapping the table.
I'm sorry.
I don't have anything for this, so you're going to have to say everything.
I don't want to say everything.
Let's just do one.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, I'm ready.
Go ahead.
Don't look at me.
That shirt is horrendous.
I said that?
Would you say that?
Would I say? No.
Oh, I have a good one.
That was stupid.
Okay. Well, you have to say if that is something he would say.
Did I say that?
No.
I didn't say it.
Okay, ready? Ready for this one? Also, this is dumb because no one in the audience gets this.
But everybody knows Nik Morton. Everybody loves
Nik. Everyone knows Nik.
Okay, ready? Hello, ladies.
I've definitely said that on a multitude of times.
That's it. That's all we have.
You nerd.
Every morning, it's like, what's up, ladies?
Yeah.
Good morning, ladies.
Can't say it. Can't say
or
it.
Or sometimes it's a,
the way Nik Morton says ladies. it's different from everybody else. Because the way you say it is just different.
Is that
it's because he says it very casually. He doesn't try to do it as a joke. It's just the only thing that he says.
My favorite one is always when Nik Morton goes, you nerd.
You nerd.
Sure, he says like, that.
It's just funny.
I don't know why it's funny.
I think it's funny.
Makes me cry. I go home and cry.
Do you?
No.
You know why I cry?
Why?
I can't tell you.
Why'd you bring it up? You can't do that on a show.
I hate it when people do that. You ever get a text where somebody is like, oh no, like just straight up, oh no. And then you're like,
that's a weird.
What? It is like, well, I don't know if I should tell you. It'd be like,
I hate that.
Excuse me? No, you can't come to me with, oh no.
I hate when people
have me ask what and then not tell me.
Yeah, I hate when people text you and they're like, can I be honest? Like, no, just lie to me.
Yeah, exactly.
Totally fine.
Can I be honest about something?
Can I tell you a secret?
No.
It's like no, exactly. When they say,
I don't care.
Can I tell you a secret? It's like, you now have to.
Yeah.
You,
or it's yeah, like, then you're like, yeah, let me hear the secret. And they're like, actually, never mind. Like,
it's like,
no.
Well,
it's like,
you can drown yourself.
Jesus.
That's not okay.
Yeah.
It's just like, I'm sad. Can you talk to me? No, I'm busy. I'm eating. I just made this really nice sandwich, and I don't really want you to ruin it.
I'm really happy about it, and your sadness is making me sad.
Yeah, it's really bringing me down.
Nick, you don't open a lot of your emails.
Why are you
going through his emails?
What do you mean? What email is that? I open every email.
You've got a lot of emails.
You have a lot of emails.
Oh, I don't open any of those. I don't care about those.
UPS.
My package was delivered today.
Penny Palooza. Earn 30% off with JP Penny.
I don't know. Sometimes.
JP Penny?
JP Penny.
JC Penny?
Yeah.
Oh, it's because I wanted to. My friend works at JC Penny and I wanted to talk. So I signed up for a membership.
That's, what do you mean?
Why didn't you just go there and talk?
Yeah.
Because there were people behind me.
Oh.
So I signed up for a membership.
Oh. Wait, okay. So you held the store.
I was stalling to talk.
That's funny, actually.
And now I just get bombarded with JCPenney emails.
Wait, this is your school account. How are you getting JCPenney?
No, it's not. Can you get out of my email, please?
Yeah.
How many emails does he have?
Oh, my God.
I winked at the camera for if you didn't see that.
Okay.
The backyard scientist.
We're done. We're done. Backyard scientist. Have you seen his videos? They're inspirational.
Will a drop of water on the anvil make it explode?
Yes.
The answer is
can
maybe.
Can you tell us
the answer? I didn't watch the video. As you can see from me well, not then. Opening the email.
Yeah, true. Done with that. I closed it.
Okay, what's next?
Well, we have exactly 7 minutes left on our show.
Yeah.
7 minutes and 20 seconds.
So let's think of a closer. Probably a message from our sponsor.
Oh,
from
yeah.
From our
paper?
Sponsor. I just went away. Yeah. Paper and the water bottle that is now gone. I've drinking like a sip this entire episode.
Drinking?
I drank a whole water bottle.
Drinking?
Pretty much. 1 second.
Drink.
I've gotten pretty far.
No, you haven't.
Brought to you by.
It looks like I'm drinking a lot.
This is brought to you by Flying you. Objects.
Don't do that.
Yeah. Why oh, not? Everything's broken now.
You just broke the studio's on fire.
That is a plot. We can't tell that story, Nick.
We have.
We can't. We literally can't. That's actually why? Like against.
Okay. No. See what you guys are doing right now. I don't know what you're talking about, and you're doing the same thing we just talked about.
We won't name names.
We should tell them about.
Yes.
Okay. Let me
actually,
tell.
There's
them. Don't do that. Tell the story. I don't know what
there's
you're talking
a person.
About.
Does he still go to the school?
He lives in Australia now. He moved to Australia.
No way.
How do you?
That's crazy.
Yeah, he's in Australia.
You're gonna have to tell me who this is after the show.
Yes, we will.
So anyway.
So Tom.
No, just this kid.
This kid.
I miss him so much. He was so funny.
He was.
Tell the damn story.
I
want to know.
He has Down syndrome.
Is it Down syndrome?
I think so.
Okay. He is on the spectrum. I think that's what you're supposed to call it
now.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh. But like, I don't think it's that much,
but
it is.
He functioned as a normal
kid.
Human being, you know, like
he
had all normal classes and everything, and
yeah,
he didn't really get.
I think the social thing is more of the downside. But
but he was the nicest kid you'd ever met.
Yeah, but so in my intro class, Nick was kind of like a supervisor and stuff.
Advanced, they mix up the classes,
and me and this kid, and then a girl.
Yeah.
We would just like joke around and stuff. And I don't even, how does the studio being set on fire start?
Because I think the girl, she said, I think the studio's on fire. And
as a joke.
Yeah.
And then he just went, he would always go around just like saying like, oh, the studio's on fire.
Not that I used his name.
Yeah, I know. I was going to say.
Wait, did you?
Yeah. Nick used his name. And
I'll just bleep it out.
I'll bleep it out in post. Now I know who you're talking about. Now I know what the story is.
Okay. But another thing that we do is, I don't know how that thing started
Mickey
either.
Mickey Mayonnaise.
Oh, my God.
That was, everyone.
That's going
to
be in the lower third.
One day he came
right
up to me and he was like, what's up, Nikki Mayonnaise?
It's
like,
no,
what?
It's because the girl told him to tell you that, or to call you that.
Oh, did she?
Yeah.
Okay. I do,
remember, you guys, you know, wait, we saw this person riding into town on the bike.
We'll get to that. We'll get to that.
Yeah, we'll get to that. Okay, but anyway, so I don't know how it started, but one time we were...
Was I in this class?
No.
No.
Yes.
You were. Yeah, I was definitely in this class.
You were.
Were we in the same intro class?
Yeah.
You were in intro? I thought you were in like news gathering or something.
I was like double enrolled in
why were you
intro
in my class?
And
oh, were
you were definitely
business.
In my intro class.
Yeah. But why don't I remember like you?
Were you? Because we weren't
friends.
We didn't know each other. Yeah. Okay, but anyway. He would always say like, it's too dark in here. I can't hear you.
Oh, that no, because I said that
too loud in here. I can't see you.
I said that to him once and then he just never stopped saying it. Yeah. Like one day there's so we have this audio mixer and we have this tone generator. And for people who don't know what a tone, it sends like perfect audio through the mixer so you can get a sense of.
Talk to them. Don't talk
perfect
to us.
Perfect audio. Well, now I'm talking. Now I'm talking to you.
Yeah, I know. It was wasted.
So what happened is I turned it up as loud as it could go. And it's just this annoying.
Awful sound.
That noise. Yeah, that. And he's legitimately
kinda
trying.
Worked.
He's legitimately trying to ask me a question about technology or something. And he's like, I can't get this iPad to work. And I turn it way up. I'm like, I can't hear you. I mean, I was like, I can't hear you. The tone's too loud. And he just asked me the question again. Like, he doesn't think it's a joke. he actually thinks that the tone is too loud for me to hear him, so he just keeps yelling at me. And
you're awful.
it was really funny.
Did you use his name again?
Yeah, I'll just.
Oh my god!
Just look at that. Continue story.
So another time he was like, "There's this girl in the studio, other girl," and he was like, "Can you tell her to come in? Can you tell her to meet me in the studio, please?" And I was like, "Why?" He's like, "Just do it." And I was like, "Girl B,
you wouldn't let him get away
you
with
need
it.
To go into the studio. The kid wants to talk to you."
The bleep wants to talk to you.
He's like, "You're a wet, slimy fish." And I was like, "What? Where did that come from?"
It came from Girl B.
And he always would come up to me and he'd say, could you tell the teacher that the studio's on fire? Could you tell him, can we make a joke? Can we joke with him and tell him that I spilt water on the audio mixer?"
No.
And I was like, "I'm not doing that."
Yeah.
That was pretty funny.
Because that would funny, that'd kid. Be so awful, even if that was a joke.
Yeah.
With said teacher.
Well, he obviously wouldn't believe it. But.
Yeah. He joked about it, too. I think he...
Oh, yeah. He was definitely...
He was in on a few of them.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure everyone he said, was. Pretty sure he said Nicky Mayonnaise. Pretty sure.
Probably. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised.
Anyway, so Nick, we were in class one morning, and Nick says that he saw this kid riding...
It wasn't me. No, it was the girl.
It was the girl?
Girl A.
Oh, it was girl A.
Was walking with her friend.
So, yeah, right.
And saw this kid
riding his bike.
Let me
tell a story.
Yeah, you got it.
So he's riding his bike.
I get to tell the joke again.
towards Keene, and
like the town part of Keene.
Yeah, downtown. Yeah,
central.
And he's not using his hands at all. He's just biking without his hands. And he sees the girl and he starts waving his arms and he said, "The studio's on fire." And he's like, "You're a wet, slimy fish." And he just doesn't use his hands. Like, I mean, I can ride a bicycle without my hands, but not at that magnitude.
Maybe he just always does that all day.
Yeah, he didn't touch the bike, she said.
It's pretty cool.
I would like to do that. I mean, it's not hard, but every once in a while you need to grab that.
The handles.
And we are running out of time.
Yeah.
We have about 20 and on that seconds note, left in our show.
Yeah. We'd like to thank you guys all for watching.
Watching our first
watching
episode.
And listening.
Yeah.
And listening.
I
yeah.
promise so it will get better.
Unless they turn down the volume.
With 10 seconds left, I'm Nick.
I'm Bo.
I'm Miles.
And this is BNM Radio, I think.
We'll see you next time.
We'll all see right. you next time.